We saw smoke. Heading your way.
Don't start without us.
You better hurry.
I'm just saying, there's more members of Juniper in this team than RWBY. It just makes sense to go with that one.
But Junior isn't a color.
Ugh. How can I be more clear? One, two, three. That's more than one.
But we're helping RWBY with her objective. Wouldn't that make her the leader?
Guys, we need to focus. Also, Junior is way cooler.
Exactly!
Attention away from RWBY.
Can you use the
doesn't care about its body.
Plus, it can keep grabbing new limbs.
But it's protecting its face.
We can't break it.
If we knocked all of its limbs off at once, then went for the... Guys, I got it! We hit it harder.
Is that it?
No, seriously. It's trying to keep us from its face. If we kill the limbs, we'll have a shot to kill the whole thing.
All right. Come on, team. Let's do this. Yeah!
Right.
Ren, left. RWBY, right. Nora, you ready to try out the new upgrade? Right. Then I will...
Ah!
everything you've got! Another victory for Team Junior. All right, you know, okay, Ren, I think you're onto something. It's just not sounding great anymore.
We truly can't thank you enough.
Just doing our job, sir.
That Geist had been plaguing our village for weeks. We were beginning to wonder if we'd have to relocate.
Well, we are on our way to Mistral. You could always come along with us if you don't feel safe.
I take it you're not from these parts. Anima is a large continent. I'm afraid our people would never survive the long trek to Mistral. It may be safer in the kingdoms, but we prefer our way of life. I just wish we could pay you more.
Our previous arrangement is more than sufficient.
There you go, son. It's gonna be heavier than you used to, but you'll thank me the next time you go up against a set of claws.
Wow. I don't know what to say.
Don't gotta say anything. Just put it on. I'll go get the rest.
So, what are you waiting for?
Oh, right. Guess I was gonna grow out of it eventually.
A sign of progress.
Progress. What is it?
What is that?
What, my hoodie? I've always had this.
It's got a cute little bunny rabbit!
It's Pumpkin Pete, you know, from the cereal.
What did you do? Send it a box top for a prize?
Yeah, 50!
Well, I suppose we don't have to grow out of everything.
Can't have a huntsman without his weapon. Made all the modifications you asked for. That was some fine metal you brought me. Accents the white nicely. Where'd you get it from?
From a friend.
Up all right, don't you think?
He certainly does.
I still think a grenade launcher would have really brought the look together.
Nothing's gonna stop Team Ranger now.
Team Junior.
Still not a color.
It doesn't matter what we're called. As long as we're together.
You kids sure you won't stick around? You've been real good to this town.
Sorry, but we've got another mission.
Make it to Haven Academy. No matter what.
We've heard the next village over has a working airship.
No way to know for sure. Scroll signals were bad enough out here when Beacon Tower was still up. Haven't heard from Shion Village in a while.
Well, there's only one way to find out.
Huh.
Food.
Check.
Water.
Check.
How about ammo?
Locked and loaded. Thank you, Schneed Dust Company.
Got the map?
Ren's got it.
No, I don't. You have it.
Wait, what?
Guys, please tell me you're joking. Guys.
Nope.
Do you believe in destiny? Yes.
John.
We're not lost. The next town is Shion. My family used to visit it all the time.
Oh, yeah. Don't you have, like, 4 sisters?
7.
You know, that actually explains a lot.
Wait, what do you mean?
So, what did you guys do there?
Oh, all sorts of stuff. Over here is a great hiking trail, and over here is where we went camping all the time. I got my own tent because I was special. Also, so my sisters would stop braiding my hair.
Didn't like the look?
Yeah, they just kept doing pigtails, but personally, I think I'm more of a warrior's wolf tail kind of guy.
That's just a ponytail.
I stand by what I said.
Guys?
What? Can take turns carrying him.
I don't know if he'll make it.
He will. He has to.
If we get going now, his chances will be better. I can run ahead and look for help.
Guys.
Should we bury him?
We should go. It's not safe here.
Ren? It'll be okay.
I'm just tired of losing everything.
All right, Jean. Just like we practiced, follow these instructions. Shield up. Keep your grip tight. Don't forget to keep your front foot forward. Ready? Go. Again. And again. Okay. Now, assuming you aren't cheating, we can take a break. I know this can be frustrating. And it can feel like so much effort to progress such a small amount. But I want you to know that I'm proud of you. I've never met someone so determined to better themselves. You've grown so much since we started training. And I know this is just the beginning. Jean, I I want you to know that I'm just happy to be a part of your life. I'll always be here for you, Jean. All right, Jean. Just like we practiced, follow these instructions. Shield up. Keep your grip tight. Don't forget to keep your front foot forward. Ready? Go. Again. And again.
Come on, guys. If we pick up the pace, we can hit the next town before sunset.
Assuming it's still there.
Of course it'll be there. This one's supposed to be pretty big.
Higanbana. It's a well-protected village with a popular inn.
Which means no camping in the rain. See? Everything's gonna be fine.
You know, we've had a lot of ups and downs, but things could be a lot worse. I really thought we'd see more grim.
As did I.
I guess our luck is finally turning around. To Higanbana!
To Higanbana!
Upstairs, red eyes. Said you wouldn't mind bottom shelf.
Thanks.
But I went ahead and gave you top. Lucky you.
So, what do you want?
A girl can't just catch up with her family.
She can, but you're not. How about we get on with it? Unless you plan on keeping these coming.
Does she have it?
Did you know Yang lost her arm?
That's not...
Rhetorical question. I know you know. It's just obnoxious that you'd bring up family and then carry on like your own daughter doesn't exist.
I saved her.
Once. Because that was your rule, right? Real mom of the year material, sis.
I told you Beacon would fall, and it did. I told you Ozpin would fail, and he has. Now you tell me... Does Salem have it?
I thought you weren't interested in all of that.
I just want to know what we are up against.
And which we are you referring to? You should come back, Raven. The only way we beat her is by working together. all of us.
You're the one who left. The tribe raised us, and you turned your back on them.
They were killers and thieves.
They were your family.
You have a very skewed perception of that word.
I lead our people now. And as leader, I will do everything in my power to ensure our survival.
I saw. The people of Shion saw too.
The weak die. The strong live. Those are the rules.
Well, you've certainly got someone strong on your side. I've seen the damage.
We couldn't have known the Grimm would set in as quickly as they did.
I'm not talking about the Grimm. And I'm not talking about you either.
If you don't know where the relic is, then we have nothing left to talk about.
I don't know where the Spring Maiden is either. But if you do, I need you to tell me.
And why would I do that?
Because without her, we're all going to die.
And which we are you referring to?
Make this one a double.
Another day, another adventure. What's on the agenda today?
Walking.
With a side of...
Walking.
Aw. Haven is a lot farther away than I thought.
RWBY, how long did you think this journey was going to take?
I don't know. I grew up in a small area. I've never been this far away from home.
Right, but how long?
Maybe like, 2 weeks?
What?
Okay, fine. 3 or something. Look, whatever. Hey, what's that?
That's strange. I didn't think we'd be hitting another village for a few days.
Are those buildings damaged?
We should search for survivors!
Seems like the town was abandoned.
Hey, I think I found something! Ani Yuri. Never heard of it.
Me neither.
I have. You might think of it as Anima's Mountain Glen, had it never been completed. Years ago, the richest members of Mistral were unhappy with how the kingdom was being run. Frustrated with the council, they pooled their resources together to build their own city, with their own laws. They hoped that one day, it could maybe even become its own kingdom. Many thought it would be the future. I know my parents did.
What happened?
What always happens.
The Grimm.
Not just anyone.
One?
Come on, let's just get through here. This place gives me the creeps.
We're not looking for a fight!
Who are you?
Who I am matters not to you. Or you. Or... well, you do interest me. No, I only matter to you.
Me?
You haven't the slightest clue, do you? Oh, how exciting this must be!
What do you want?
The rose has thorns! My little flower, I'm here to whisk you away with me.
Well, what if she doesn't want to go with you?
Well, I'll take her.
We're not going to let you do that.
Good.
John!
Live and breathe, Qrow Bronwyn. A true huntsman has entered the fray.
I don't know. This guy's weird.
Look, pal, I'm not sure who you are, but you need to leave my niece alone.
Why, friend, my name is Tyrion, and I'm afraid that is not possible. My assignment from Her Grace was to retrieve this young girl. So, that is what I must do. One does not upset the Queen.
Queen?
Salem.
Who?
I think we've had enough talk now, don't you?
You took the words right out. Thank you.
Fine!
How did you get here?
Why are people after RWBY?
Uncle Qrow, what's going on?
What's your favorite fairy tale? Really? No questions?
Of course we have questions. This is just a lot to take in.
Sure, of course.
So these maidens, they're powerful fighters that don't need dust to use magic.
Yeah.
And there are four of them?
Yep. Always.
Which means that whenever one of them dies, the power transfers to someone, a female, that they care about?
Whoever was in their thoughts last. Important distinction. Best option, it's someone we can trust. Regardless, their souls become combined, in a way.
And that's what you were trying to do to Pyrrha. The night the tower fell. You were trying to turn her into one of them.
The previous Fall Maiden, Amber, had been attacked. She was young, inexperienced. And her assailant, who we now know as Cinder, somehow managed to steal some of her power, but not all of it. We were afraid that if we didn't do something, the rest would go to her as well.
So you forced it on Pyrrha?
We didn't force anything. We explained the situation and gave her a choice, and she chose. You were there. You heard her.
That guy, Tyrion. Why was he after me?
Well, you definitely painted a target on your back with what you did at Beacon. I told you having silver eyes is a rare trait. And the fact that you're someone that was able to use them seems to have upset some very powerful people. Not many people know about the Silver Eyes, but those that do aren't very happy that one has surfaced. That's why I've been keeping an eye on you. Wanted to make sure you were safe. All of you.
Well, then, why not just travel with us? It seems like that would have been way easier.
He was using you as bait.
Look, I wouldn't put it like that. It's complicated.
What is all of this? RWBY's being hunted. The schools are being attacked. All for what? What is the point of all of this? Will you just tell us what's going on?
Would you sit down? You're stressing me out, kid. Not many people are super religious these days. This world's been around for a long time. Long enough that people have created dozens of gods. But if you believe Ozpin, two of them are actually real. They were brothers. The older sibling, the god of light, found joy in creating forces of life. Meanwhile, the younger brother, the god of darkness, spent his time creating forces of destruction. As you can imagine, they both had pretty different ideas about how things should go. The older one would spend his days creating water, plants, wildlife. And at night, his brother would wake to see all the things that the elder had made and become disgusted. To counteract his brother's creations, the god of darkness brought drought, fire, famine. All that he could do to rid Remnant of life. Life always returned. So one night, younger brother went and made something. Something that shared his innate desire to destroy anything and everything.
The creatures of Grimm.
You guessed it. The older brother had finally had enough. Knowing that their feud couldn't last like this forever, he proposed that they make one final creation. Together. Something they could both be proud of. Their masterpiece. Younger brother agreed. This last great creation would be given the power to both create and destroy. It would be given the gift of knowledge, so that it could learn about itself and the world around it. And most importantly, it would be given the power to choose, to have free will to take everything it had learned and decide which path to follow, the path of light or the path of darkness. And that is how humanity came to be.
But what does that have to do with us?
Well, that's the kicker. See, the four gifts to mankind, knowledge, creation, destruction, and choice, aren't just metaphorical. Each of them exists in a physical form, left behind by the gods before they abandoned Remnant. And each of them is extraordinarily powerful. If someone were to collect all four, they'd be able to change the world. And that's exactly what the enemy wants. The Huntsman Academies were created to train generations of humanity's protectors, but they also serve another purpose, guarding the relics. When Ozpin's predecessor founded the schools, he built them around the relics to act as a fortress. Not only would they be easier to defend, but they would be constantly surrounded by trained warriors. The hope was that hiding the relics would keep mankind from using them against itself. And of course, keeping them out of her reach. So, yeah, there's that.
Her. You mean Salem?
That's right. Not much is known about her, and quite frankly, that's not what matters. What matters right now is that she wants the relics. And if she gets them, it's not going to end well.
All right, so let's say we believe all of this. There really is this crazy evil being behind these attacks, not just some thugs trying to become powerful. Why doesn't the world know? Why isn't Atlas going after them, or Mistral?
And why aren't we in more of a hurry to get to Haven? Shouldn't we be getting them a message? What if they're next?
The headmaster over there saw what happened to Beacon. He's not dumb, he'll be on his guard. Besides, it takes time to mobilize forces like that. Do you really think they planned out that attack on Beacon overnight? And to answer your question, it's the same reason we keep quiet about the Maidens. If the whole world knew about the relics, about Salem, it would be chaos. We'd have another great war on our hands, and this time, you'd have to fight. Look, I had the same questions too. But old Ozpin always put his foot down. We can't cause a panic. I can't tell you how many times I've heard that. Salem's smart. She works from the shadows, using others to get what she wants, so that when it comes time to place the blame, we can only point at each other. She's trying to divide us, humanity. And so far, she's done a pretty damn good job.
All right. So, what should we do?
I don't really know. Ozpin has put a lot of trust in the headmasters. Like I said, the schools are an important part of stopping Salem. Atlas is going to be on high alert after the last attack, and Vacuo is, well, Vacuo. It'll be hard to hire thieves and scoundrels to fight against other thieves and scoundrels. Take that. Add in the fact that Cinder and her crew claim to be from Haven, and I think it's likely the next target. So, we're on our way to the headmaster. Haven't heard from him in a while, even before the attack. I'm hoping he has the answers. All right. I think it's time you kids got some sleep.
Uncle Qrow?
Yeah?
This is a lot to take in. And it all sounds crazy. But I'm willing to do whatever I can to help. Because I trust you. But why couldn't you trust me? Why couldn't you just travel with us instead of all of this secrecy and...
Look, this has nothing to do with trust. It's a long story, okay?
Seriously? Now you're tired of telling us stories?
Did you know that crows are a sign of bad luck? Old superstition, but it's how I got my name. You see, some people can absorb electricity, and some people can burst into rose petals. And some people are just born unlucky. My semblance isn't like most. It's not exactly something I do. It's always there, whether I like it or not. I bring misfortune. I I guess you could call me a bad luck charm. Comes in real handy when I'm fighting an enemy. But it makes it a little hard on friends and family.
Well, you are just a real bundle of help, aren't you?
Yeah.
Where are you going?
Taking a walk.
There's nothing else you want to tell us?
Not tonight.
We should probably get moving.
Yeah.
Without the map, there's no way of knowing. But I feel like we're close to something.
What is it? Hey, Mistral! We're on the right path! Oh. Does it say how close?
No. And it looks like the path takes us up through the mountains.
Guys, I don't know if all of us can make that climb.
Okay, well, what about this place? Qrow, Yuri! Can we get help there?
That village was destroyed years ago.
But if it takes us around the mountains, it's the best bet we've got.
It will take too long.
The town would have had a doctor, right? Well, maybe we could scavenge for medicine.
Right!
You're not going to find anything. We just have to press on.
Ren, why are you acting?
We can split up.
Huh?
Ren and I can cut through the mountains while you and RWBY take Qrow around through the village.
No, we're supposed to stick together. We keep each other safe.
We don't have time for safe. If we make it to Mistral, we'll bring back help. If we don't, we'll at least have a better view of the land. Up there, we can see if there's somewhere else we can go.
Okay. Take care of each other.
We always have.
They're gonna be fine, John.
You don't know that.
these places look like a pharmacy?
It's honestly hard to tell.
Ren really didn't want to come here, did he?
Didn't seem so.
Do you know why?
I think I have a pretty good idea.
Trying to catch a fish?
I found the flower on the water!
Oh, I see.
Can we take it home and plant it in the garden?
Oh, no, sweetheart. That flower lives here. But I'll tell you what you can do. Take this lien and go find something nice for your father's return. He's been hunting for quite some time. I bet the journey's been very tiring, don't you?
Yes.
Do you think you'll know what he wants?
I think he wants a water flower in the garden.
Why did you have to inherit my sass?
Buy with this?
Well, something just your size.
Socket, please.
See you pay for it, thief!
No, look, it's all moldy!
I think she got it from the trash!
Let me see! Ah! She bit me! Where'd she come from?
She's dressed all weird.
I bet she's a bear. Like a dog or something.
Does that mean I have rabies?
What is happening here? Do you wish to run with the rest of them? Sometimes the worst action to take is taking no action at all. Go home. I need to speak with the mayor.
Nothing.
We should get back to Qrow.
I know, but Ren and Nora are still out there.
I'm sorry.
Huh?
This is all my fault. I should have never dragged you guys into this.
You didn't drag us in. We wanted to come.
But you didn't know about Tyrion, about...
RWBY. We lost... we lost Pyrrha. You lost her too. And Penny, and your team, and in a way, your sister. But you're still here. Despite everything you've lost, and everything you could still lose, you chose to come out here. Because you felt like you could make a difference. You didn't drag us along. You gave us the courage to follow you.
Blight, get up. We have to go.
Mother?
No, right now, okay? Let's go. Lee!
On! What are you doing? We need to hurry!
We can go to the safe house.
No. I saw the beast. We need a huntsman. And you two need to leave.
What?
Mother!
It's okay, darling. Everything's okay.
Brave.
Thank you.
to. It's okay. We'll keep each other safe. What's your name?
Nora.
My name's Lairen.
We never get the easy path, do we?
Easy's no fun anyway. You okay?
And you?
I've got you here, don't I? Come on, there's more than one way up a mountain.
I suppose there's only one way to find. Yes, yes. Very funny.
Hey, what's wrong?
This is the symbol for Shion Village.
Shion? But that's. That's the village where we found the huntsman. It's weeks away from here. Red? Wait! Oh my gosh!
Not again.
What are you guys doing here?
Did you hear that noise? What was that? Wait. Do you guys hear that?
No.
Ren?
Thank you.
Just get him to safety!
Going to get hurt if we don't.
No. I won't let you kill yourself like this. After everything we've been through, I won't let it end. Not like this.
Hmm.
We can do this. Take care of the horse.
And I'll take care of the rest. Myself.
Saw the smoke. No one's been out here for years. Thought something might be wrong.
What if we don't make it in time?
RWBY.
We made it, Uncle Qrow. hope my letters have been reaching you and Dad. Handwritten stuff's never been super reliable, but I guess it's all we've got these days. Anyway, in case you haven't been getting them, I want to say I'm sorry for leaving the way I did. I know you told me it was a reckless idea, and after everything I've been through, I can definitely say you were right. It's been hard on all of us. And I'm not just talking about the monsters we fought out here.
Okay, you can hide out back in the cargo hold. I'll take you as far as I can, but if we get caught, you're on your own. Understand?
Every step we made took us further and further away from the things we knew. And every morning we woke up wondering if just over the next hill would be something good. Or something terrible. It's scary, not knowing what's going to happen next. And the things we do know now, just how bad it can get, it almost makes it all worse. You told me once that bad things just happen. You were angry when you said it, and I didn't want to listen. But you were right. Bad things do happen. All the time. Every day. Which is why I'm out here. To do whatever I can. Wherever I can. And hopefully do some good. We've all lost something. And I've seen what loss can do to people. But if we gave up every time we lost, then we'd never be able to move forward. We'd never have a chance to see what beautiful things the future might have waiting for us. We'd never have the strength to change, whether it's ourselves or the world around us. And we'd never be there for other people who might one day be lost without us. This is what we were training for, Yang. To become huntresses. To be the ones to stand up and do something about all the bad in the world.
Approaching City of Mistral.
Because there are plenty of people out there who are still lost. And even more who will try to gain everything they can from their sorrow. Believe me when I say, I know it can feel impossible. Like every single day is a struggle against some unstoppable monster we can never hope to beat. But we have to try. If not for us, then for the people we've already... Then for the people we haven't lost yet. I miss you so much. I miss Weiss and Blake too. But I think you'd all be proud to know that I made it to Mistral. All of us did. And we even ran into Uncle Qrow along the way.
Hey, Aren't I normally the one saving you?
He's going to take us to see Professor Lionheart, the headmaster of Haven Academy. And he told us some things that you're gonna want to hear. Things I can't trust will make it to you in this letter. But maybe, if you joined us, he could tell you himself. With Beacon gone, they'll need Dad at Signal more than ever. And I know you need to focus on yourself before I can expect you to come out with me. But it sure would be great to get Team RWBY back together again.
You are in so much trouble when I find you.
Until next time, your loving sister, RWBY Rose.
P.S. I'll be sure to give you the address of where we'll be staying in Mistral. I'd love to hear back from you and Dad, and I can't wait to fill you in on whatever's going to happen next. Now that we've made it across Anima, I really think things are going to start going our way.
Why, thank you, Professor. Salem always did say you were quite hospitable.
Excuse me.
You know, I don't think they allow kids in here, Pipsqueak.
Shut up, I'm getting there. I'm supposed to tell you, I'd like my cane back.
Good to see you again, Oz.